Right, Uncle Bass, thank you for having us in your office.
You're welcome, Simon.
And we're happy to be here. Can you tell us a little bit about Kanship when you started?
Well, Kanship, well, Consolidated Shipping Agencies, okay, which is now also known as Kanship, started in 1996.
Okay.
First February 1996, and then operationally first April 1996.
Oh, okay.
We started off as a small custom house agency.
Hmm.
Worked our way through to 1999 when we had our first major breakthrough with a US company that was listed on the stock exchange in the US.
Okay.
So that opened the door to international business for us. Okay. We got to see how things are done. We enjoyed the FCPA process for the first time in 1999.
Okay.
So from that time to basically the year 2010, we kept on growing in the oil and gas industry. 2003 to 2007, we're actively involved with Chevron with the West Africa Gas Pipeline project. So those businesses did give us the exposure into the market, and more especially into oil and gas. So as of today, we are well about 200 people. We have branches in Houston, in Chicago, Tema, Accra, Tema, Accra, Takrady, where we have our projects and oil and gas going seriously. We have a very good clientele, the oil and gas, more especially, both international and local.
Yeah.
Every client we have, we definitely have to do SOPs with them, go through the process. And Kanship proudly is also a TRACE member.
Okay.
In 2015, there was the global TRACE and a global anti-bribery workshop in Ghana. TRACE asked me to join them to be on the panel, and that, I think that was one of the achievements that brought us into the limelight.
Wow.
So we've been growing from strength to strength. 65% of our business is more oil and gas.
Okay.
And then the 35% is for the vertical markets.
Okay.
When I say vertical markets, the thing that always that moves. And we also work for some of the telcos.
Okay.
And Mantrack. And some of the members of AmCham actually are our clients, so we are very happy too.
Oh, thank you. This is very impressive. But talking of oil and gas, you are doing something very unique this year at OTC. Would you care to share with our members what's happening? Why is it the first, and why has it taken us so long to get to this point?
Well, I have been visiting OTC since 2008. That was my first OTC when I was invited by one of our customers. And I saw what was happening. But at that time, we were working for oil and gas companies in Nigeria, in Cameroon, out of Ghana, so there was no relation. Sopon oil field was just doing a little bit. But I felt it was something very good that we should partake. And then in 2010, we found oil. Every year we go as delegates, but why are we not showcasing what we have in country? Why are we not telling the world what is here? It's an opportunity for business owners and businesses to know what is available in Ghana and where Ghana stands in. So we've been talking about it. I've talked to two chief executives of GMPC. Why can't we do this? Why can't we be here and everything? But it looks like most of the things you have to, you know, there's a big gap between a private business and state enterprises. So bureaucracy always drag things about. So this year, after the award of the maritime dispute for Ghana, we decided to take a bold step. We approached SPE in Houston to find out if Ghana can have a pavilion for the first time. And they came up with a 27-page contract. So after the maritime border dispute, we felt there was a need for us. So we approached SPE. SPE came up with a 28-page contract. We had to give it to our lawyers to look at it because this is an international exhibition or an international offer. So we went through it and we took a huge risk. a very big risk. So in October, when we announced the OTC for Ghana, I tell you, for the first 2 months, nobody signed up. Nobody was interested. So it took a lot of effort for us to tell people the reason why they have to be here. And today, as we speak today, all the boats are sold out. And
congratulations.
And we have even a few people trying to get in now.
Oh.
It was tough. Getting the ministry actively involved was difficult. But I think it's good for the first time. And we hope that by the time we come back, people will see the reason why the next event, they have to be part of it.
Okay.
For next year.
Okay.
We're hoping to do 25 boats next year.
Yes, yeah.
And we hope that people will really get to see the opportunities are here. When you have, you know, multinational companies drilling here, the likes of Talo, ENI, Hess, ACA, and Exceed, and all that gonna come in here. There's a need for, and it, you see, it also empowers, it empowers local content. Because if you have indigenous companies like ourselves going to showcase what we can do for the world, it's easier. It makes you to be able to strike business accounts and come up with JVs and so on. So we thought it was the best thing to do for the country.
Okay.
We will not take pride in it because we're doing it for Mother Ghana.
For Mother Ghana.
Okay. So we will not take pride in it. So we hope that it will. And fantastic support from the US Commissar Service. They have supported us very well. Because when we talk to them about it, they bought into the vision because they have been taking the delegates every year. So we signed an MOU with them. And we are very happy that from now we've got American companies even going to exhibit
the Ghana Pavilion. And also, if you can tell us a little bit about the opening ceremony. We know there is some program around
the Ghana Pavilion. So in conjunction with the Houston Chamber of Commerce and then the Ministry of Energy with the and the U.S. Embassy, the Minister for Energy will be there on the 30th of April.
Okay.
We'll have a small ceremony. Mm-hmm. We'll have the Adowa dance.
Okay.
The kente kind of thing over there. We've got the press involved. We want to be able to make sure that they get the message back to Ghana. The minister is personally excited about it and that he's going to have this done. And I think under his watch, every minister will be happy to make sure that.
Nice.
So the event is there, and then the U.S. Commercial Session has also planned some other events as well.
Okay.
We have one of the exhibitors also who want to host the Ghanaian delegation on the Wednesday, the 2nd of May. And I think that is very, very welcome for us to have that exposure. They also plan. And then we also have a standard invitation to the other pavilions, Nigeria, Angola, and all that, to also come for the opening event. And I think it's going to be a very, it's a beautiful thing.
Wow, that's great. That's great. This is good. But let me just take you back a little bit. So, how many U.S. companies are you affiliated with?
Well, there are a couple of them.
Okay.
A couple of them. Apart from the Conship organization, we have Eco Alpha.
Okay. That's great.
Now, Eco Alpha is a new company, just recently registered, about 6 months old. And Eco Alpha is going to do specialized equipment, including aviation. And we registered with PC as well, so we'll be partaking in, you know, tenders and things that will come out for, you know, aviation tenders and things. But interestingly, we have the Africa dealership for a company called Sika Aircraft.
Okay.
Sika Aircraft actually manufactures this very light aircraft that can cruise up to 6 hours. And it's got a superiority over a chopper.
Okay.
It fits into a 20-foot container so easily. It looks like a chopper, but it has wings.
Okay.
And we are hoping that we can market this in the African continent. So Sika is very proud. They have released a press release on our signing. And Sika is going to be at the OTC as well.
Okay.
Now Sika is going to, they will demonstrate the capabilities of the aircraft, where you have got the facial recognition and all the software, you know, thermal imaging. We will provide free ride for those who want to go on board. So we'll have a shuttle between the center and the airfield so that we'll be able to market it. They are very powerful aircraft, good for power line inspection.
Okay.
So we're looking at local firms like Rico. We're looking at pipeline inspection when the Voltairean Basin starts.
Okay.
And all that, we want to talk to GMPC, we want to talk to the likes of Talo and other things. And we believe that for law enforcement, which is a very critical thing right now in the world, law enforcement, this Seeker aircraft will be one of the things that will be flying in Africa very soon. And it's reasonably priced.
Okay.
It costs less than $80 an hour.
Okay.
Operational cost.
Okay.
Which is 1/3 of what you normally spend on a helicopter. So we believe that this is an asset meant for Africa. It's manufactured in Australia, so they have the capability to withstand the weather in the tropics like where we are here. So I think it's good. So we are really excited about Seeker.
Okay.
But we are affiliated with most businesses in the US. Right. We are a member of the National Freight Forwarders and Customer Assistance Association in the US.
Okay.
And I can proudly say that Conship is the only indigenous company in Ghana that is FMC registered.
Okay.
FMC means that Federal Maritime Authority. So we are able to book with vessels on our own and everything. And that has actually opened the door for us to have this international freight forwarding for Talo.
Okay.
I mean, you have to go through that due diligence process. And we are really excited about that as well. And then we have the NDOCC as well. We also register with IAC. And the indirect aircraft, so we are able to make bookings on various aircrafts as well. We have a staff force of 4 in the US, both in Chicago and in Houston, and I think we are doing the very best we can. We strive very hard on compliance and governance. I've always said do the right thing, but do it right the first time.
Yeah,
it means before you do something, you have to do your checks and balances. So when you come out, you know exactly what you are. But I'm happy to say that all the 206 workers we have here in Ghana are all Ghanaians, indigenous, well-trained and certified. We are also an ISO company. So we are ISO 9001:2015. We are also compliant with OSHA. So we are ISO 18001. And it's needed for the industry. Not just the oil and gas, but for everything that we do, we have that as well.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
One last question before we leave you. Do you have any special rates for AmCham members if you want to do business with?
So what we do is we do have a market rate.
Okay.
But for some clients who are AmCham members, let me give you an instance.
Like
Cosmos. We have very good rates with them. And they are very happy with whatever we do for them. They appreciate what we do for them. And for the fact that they are also partner to the Jubilee Field. So they get to know exactly what we are also doing for the likes of Talo and Monek and Adako and all that. So they get involved in that. So we do. We do Mantrak, we're doing a very good job with Mantrak. I think they are very happy about it. And one of the things we pride ourselves was to develop a software. And this software allows the clients or the customers to have the end part of the software. So whatever documentation, whatever process, whatever we do, they get to see it live. So they have real live updates on all their shipments. If we tell you that your shipment is on its way, you can tell us that the one is going to come here and everything. And for compliance also, they are able to extract every supporting document out of the system.
Okay.
So that makes it one unique thing.
Very unique.
So you don't really have to have boxes of files because the software is on the cloud and it becomes your archiving.
Okay.
As long as you have your PO, your reference number, you just go into it, look it up, and you get everything that you want to do. Even we keep photos of shipments.
Wow.
In there.
That's very tough.
So transparency is one of the things that we do.
Okay. All right, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Bye. To your office.